Evening. Welcome to the Church of St. Peter. Please join us in singing our opening hymn, How Firm a Foundation, number 722, 722.
Well, good evening. Somebody once asked me, what's the best parish in the diocese? My standard answer is, it's the one I'm the pastor of. And so as that best parish in our diocese, I'd like to have you welcome in the spirit of St. Peter, our newly ordained priest and parochial vicar, Father Zach Samples. Thank you. So let's begin now. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. Amen. Now as we gather around the table of the Lord, we pause as we acknowledge our sins, and so get ourselves ready to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you send us forth as disciples and apostles to witness to this world. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, you call us to share your cross if we are to share your glory. Christ, have mercy. And Lord Jesus, you call us to be a people of faith, hope, and joy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all now to everlasting life. And glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. And let us pray. O God, who in the abasement of your Son have raised up a fallen world, fill your faithful with holy joy. For on those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal happiness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, "Rejoice with Jerusalem and be glad because of her. All you who love her, exult, exult with her. All you who were mourning over her, oh, that you may suck fully of the milk of her comfort, that you may nurse with delight at her abundant breast. For thus says the Lord, lo, I will spread prosperity over Jerusalem like a river, and the wealth of the nations like an overflowing torrent. As nurslings, you shall be carried in her arms and fondled in her lap. As a mother comforts her child, so will I comfort you. In Jerusalem, you shall find your comfort. When you see this, your heart shall rejoice and your bodies flourish like the grass. The Lord's power shall be known to his servants." The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, may I never boast except in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, through which the world has been crucified to me and I to the world. For neither does circumcision mean anything, nor does uncircumcision, but only a new creation. Peace and mercy be to all who follow this rule and to the Israel of God. From now on, let no one make troubles for me, for I bear the marks of Jesus on my body. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with your spirit, brothers and sisters. Amen. The word of the Lord.
And the Lord be with you. A reading from His Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. At that time, the Lord appointed 72 others, whom He sent ahead of Him in pairs to every town and place He intended to visit. He said to them, "The harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So ask the master of the harvest to send out laborers for his harvest. Go on your way. Behold, I am sending you like lambs among wolves. Carry no money bag, no sack, no sandals, and greet no one along the way. Into whatever house you enter, first say, 'Peace to this household.' If a peaceful person lives here, your peace will rest on him. But if not, it will return to him, to you. Stay in the same house and eat and drink what is offered to you, for the laborer deserves his payment. Do not move about from one house to another. Whatever town you enter and they welcome you, eat what is set before you. Cure the sick in it and say to them, 'The kingdom of God is at hand.' Whatever town you enter and they do not receive you, go out into the streets and say, 'The dust of your town that clings to our feet, even that we shake off against you.' Yet know this, the kingdom of God is at hand. I tell you, it will be more tolerable for Sodom on that day than for that town." The 72 returned, rejoicing, and said, "Lord, even the demons are subject to us because of your name." Jesus said, I have observed Satan fall like lightning from the sky. Behold, I have given you the power to tread upon serpents and scorpions and upon the full force of the enemy, and nothing will harm you. Nevertheless, do not rejoice because the spirits are subject to you, but rejoice because your names are written in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. Well, good evening. You know, as we gather on this Independence Day weekend, needless to say, one of the things that I encourage you to do is, in a very special way, to pray for our country. We are sure in need of prayer. And it doesn't matter what your political bent is, the turmoil and violence that we're experiencing is not a country of freedoms. So I challenge each of you to kindly remember our country in your prayer. Second, I got a kick out of that gospel reading. And the kick I got out, it says, when you move into a place, carry no sandals, no extra stuff with you. Well, Father Zach has moved in. He brought more than his sandals with him. But nevertheless, we're very happy that he's with us to join us. And we need, the second part of it, we need to continue to pray for vocations. The harvest is rich, but there's laborers are few. And so we need to make sure we pray for vocations. Got it? Now the homily. Sometimes we get confused. And there's two words that we want to make sure we understand fully. The two words are disciple and apostle. What are you? You a disciple or are you an apostle? Well, the correct answer is you're both. You're both. By virtue of your baptism, you are a disciple. By virtue of your confirmation, you are called to, in a very special way, to be an apostle. That's apostle with a small a. Okay? I bring that to your attention because the apostle with a large A is represented above our canopy, the 12 of them, the 12 that Jesus chose. Okay? We are not part of the 12. But by virtue of our baptisms, we're also called to proclaim the message of Jesus in our world. So what's a disciple? I think about our discipleship, and this is the very basis for having a Catholic school. Because in a Catholic school, if we are not developing discipleship, if we are not developing disciples, then why have it? The whole idea of being a disciple is, in a sense, it comes from a Latin word from which we get the word discipline. Now, we might think discipline, wow, that's a spanking if we're disobedient. No. Discipline is any way or any form that somebody uses to teach us something. So discipline means basically somehow that we're following a person or a teaching in our lives, making it a part of who we are. And Christ chose a lot of differing disciples. In fact, how many did he choose today that he sent forth? If you listen to the gospel, 72. So he had, and all the rabbis had disciples. They were people who learned from him, who studied him, embraced his teachings, and in a sense, had a love and affection for the rabbi, and made those teachings his own. Now, among the disciples, Jesus probably chose 12 in a special way. The 12 apostles, you have to, in a sense, to be an apostle, you had to be a disciple. That means you had to learn first. You had to be one of those who stuck by Jesus. And one of the qualifications of being an apostle was in a sense, you were with him since the baptism of John till his death and resurrection. So that whole qualification of apostle was to bear witness to what they experienced as a disciple, what they incorporated in their lives as a disciple. And then Jesus sent them forth. So the apostles then were basically those disciples that had a specific role. And their specific role was to go and not only bear witness, but also, in a sense, to proclaim the kingdom of God being present. What we find today is that other than the 12, Jesus now sends 72 forth. And they had the same mission. And one of the things, the beautiful parts about that gospel, is that they returned to Jesus rejoicing. People actually listened. Sometimes people were even changed. And so the disciples were filled with joy as they returned to God. Now, what this whole gospel is trying to teach us, I think, is that you and I, throughout all of our lives, will always be disciples. We're always going to be learners. I don't know about you, but as far as I'm concerned, I'm still learning my faith. Each and every day of my life, when I wake up, something happens to you. Sometimes it shakes the heck out of you. And you sometimes wonder, and you think, and you pray. We're always learning. That means we're always going to be disciples. We're always going to be disciples. And that's why we gather in church, to learn, to be molded and fashioned into Jesus and his teachings. And we may not always understand how it all works together. You know, Paul was an example of that. Paul was both a disciple and would eventually become an apostle. He was a disciple because, remember his conversion experience? He was running around the entire Holy Land trying to persecute Christians. And then all of a sudden he has this conversion experience where he's quite literally knocked off his horse. And the Lord Jesus appears to him and says, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" And Paul finally got it. But it took the early church quite a while to trust him. And so he became a disciple. He learned from the witness of the apostles, the other apostles. He learned from them. And after several years, then the church said, "Okay, we will send you forth to be the apostle to the Gentiles." And he did that over very successfully. But one of the things he learned as a disciple was that the cross is always a part of our lives. And that's what he said today in our gospel, in that second reading. "I boast in the cross of Christ." How could you do that? Because Paul figured it out. Without the cross, there is no resurrection. Without that cross, which each of us embraces, we really don't have the life that Christ wants us. And so Paul understood that. And so Paul became not only that disciple, but also he became that apostle with a capital letter A. He was sent forth. So what's all this have to say to us? Well, it says a lot. First, we're disciples. We continue to learn. The person that says, "I got it all," give you time. Something will happen. Something will shake you. But after learning and embracing the faith, then the church sends us forth. We become disciples at baptism, but we become witnesses to the faith at confirmation. That means we begin to live our faith. We begin to take our faith into our small world communities and not only live it, but be able to share it in some way. So, my brothers and sisters, wouldn't it be great if all of us, as the apostles, disciples, somehow could change our country? But the only way we're going to change our country if we begin by in the small arenas of our lives, by changing our families first. And then from families, we go into our communities. And perhaps then, after that, we can truly bear witness to the cross, to the resurrection, and all that Jesus means to all of us in our faith community, as well as in our Quincy community. And so with that, let's ask our Lord for the grace we need to be truly those apostles with a small a, as well as those disciples, as we give witness to the kingdom of God here on earth. Let's stand now. Together we profess our faith as we say, "I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth." Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. It's God's family now. I want to place these petitions before our Father.
For our church, may the Lord raise up holy men and women to humbly labor on her behalf. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For civil leaders, may the Lord guide them in their work promoting justice, peace, and truth. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are alienated from God and his holy church, may Christ's message of love and healing bring them back into his loving arms. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are sick in this faith community, may God restore them to the fullness of life and health and liberate them from all that afflicts them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, that they may know the glory and the splendor of heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our special intentions, especially for the intention of this Mass, Merle Hellick, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Perhaps the greatest witness we have for bearing witness to the gospel is our final prayer here. My church is composed of people like me. I help make it what it is. It will be friendly if I am. Its pews will be filled if I help fill them. It will do great work if I work. It will make generous gifts to many causes if I am a generous giver. It will bring other people into worship and fellowship if I invite and bring them. It will be a church of loyalty and love, of fearlessness and faith, and a church with a noble spirit if I, who make it is what it is, am filled with these same things. Therefore, with the help of God, I shall dedicate myself to the task of being all the things that I want my church to be. Amen.
Please join us in singing number 463, Come to Me, 463.
Thank you.
Pray now, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. May this oblation dedicated to your name purify us, O Lord, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the life of heaven, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. And lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks now to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed humankind in your own image and set humanity over the whole world and all of its wonder, to rule in the name of over all that you made, and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels, we praise you, and in joyful celebration we acclaim now. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts which we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. And do this in memory of me." And the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension to heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Peter and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Thomas John, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassionate, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. And to all of our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. And through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Savior's command now, informed divine teaching, we dare to say together now. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. And Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give to you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and the unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with all of you. Thank you. Let's offer to each other a sign of God's peace and his love. Peace with you. Okay. Peace with you. Brothers and sisters, now behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world, and blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Communion hymn is Here I Am, Lord, number 394, 394.
Thank you.
The Social Concerns Committee is collecting food items this weekend for the first Sunday collection for Ladies of Charities. See the bulletin for more details.
And let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that having been replenished by such great gifts, we may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you now, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Please introduce yourselves to Father Samples after Mass. Don't expect him to remember, okay? Yeah, it may take him a while. Our Mass is ended now. Let's go forth in faith to love and serve the Lord.
Go.
Defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl among the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Our closing hymn is America the Beautiful, number 745. 745.